To add classification conditional formatting, first start by selecting the metric that you would like to add the conditional formatting to. In this example, I will apply the conditional formatting to the variance percentage. I'll come up to conditional formatting on the home ribbon and go to classification. And you can see here there are three primary groups of classifications that can be added. You can apply text, icon sets, or radians. In this example, we will go ahead and apply a 5-icon set to start with. Once applied, it will also open up the conditional formatting pane. And like other conditional formatting, there's options to choose to apply the row hierarchy levels either at the values only or the totals only, as well as the values and totals. Let's go ahead and also apply it to the values and totals. Select apply, and you can now see the subtotals on rows also getting the conditional formatting icons. Additionally, the apply to over here will determine where you would like to apply the conditional formatting icons to. In addition to that, you can also choose what the conditional formatting logic is based on. So in this case, we're applying it to the variance, but we can also choose to apply it to the variance percentage, or we can have it based on other calculations as well. Under display, we have an option to choose to change from any of the other type of classifications if we want. The icon position will also let us choose if we want to place it to the left of the data, to the right of the data, or as an example, if we wanted to show the icon only. Let's go ahead and see what that looks like by hitting apply. It will remove the underlying values and just display the icon only. Let's go ahead and change that back to left of data again. Select apply. Additionally, if we scroll down below, we'll also see that we have an option to customize any of the rules as well as change the icons down here. You can use any of the icons that are built into the tool, or you can also upload your own custom icon files as well. And you can further configure by adding additional ranges if desired. Let's go ahead and look at some of the other classifications as some examples. If I change it to the ABC text and select apply, now we'll have some additional options such as showing the percentage text. If we go ahead and show this to the left and click apply, you'll see that it now provides the percentage range for these values based off of their comparison to the min and the max across all values. Last but not least, let's go ahead and explore the rating systems down here. I'll go ahead and apply a 5-star rating. And now we'll see some additional options as well. We can choose to display to the left or the right of the data or only the rating, customize the color, as well as being able to change the number of ranges if needed. So let's select apply. We can see that we're now getting the star rating as well as the original base value. Let's go ahead and actually expand this column just a little bit. There we are. And one other feature I want to mention is the rating text. If I go ahead and put that to the right and click apply, it will actually show the numerical value of whatever that rating might be. And if desired, you can also enable custom, which will let you configure the rules individually if needed.